Hey guys, Carrie Rhodes here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I have another video for you featuring a new release from Concord & Ninth. It's the Toucan Paradise Bundle. Such a cute stamp set. And for my cards, I'm gonna be featuring the gel press to make some unique backgrounds for these cards. So let's get stamping. We are starting this card off by stamping the toucan bird from the Toucan Paradise stamp set. He is like the focal image of the set and super cute. So I'm stamping it on whipped cream cardstock with VersaFine Onyx Black ink. I'm using a stamp positioning tool because I'm embossing this, and if I need to stamp it more than once, I can do that with this tool. So I stamped it down and one time seemed to be enough. So I went ahead and sprinkled on some clear embossing powder and coated that image, just tapping off the excess into a coffee filter so I can pour that back into the container. And then I'll heat up my heat gun so it's nice and hot. That way it will start melting that powder right away and it will prevent some warping of the paper. Anytime you heat paper, you'll get some warping, but heating it up really helps prevent some of that. I'm going to die cut this out before I stamp the pieces of the beak. Once it's die cut, that die cut gives you a guide where to stamp those beak pieces. So I'm inking up the first piece with Coral Berry ink from Altenew, and I wasn't quite sure which way to stamp this, but then I figured out the open part of this stamp will face to the right. And then you see there's a line down the middle of that beak. There's also a line in the pointed end piece. So you just want to try and line those two up when stamping them. And then I'll stamp the tip of this beak with Fresh Lemon ink. Trying to line those up is a little harder with the yellow ink, but there you go. And then there's a stacked line image in this stamp set that I'll be using for the feathers. And I'm using Frayed Leaf ink for those feathers. Now on to the gel press backgrounds. I'm using three Altenew green inks that come in a set together. That way I know they will work well together. And I'm just pressing those down onto the surface of my gel press, which is somewhat like, it has the feel of like a silicone baking dish, but it's made out of gel. And you can put ink or paint on the surface and make unique prints with them. I spread that ink out with my brayer, which apparently had a little bit of white paint on it, but I decided to go with it anyway, and it worked out fine. And then I'm stamping my images from the Toucan Paradise set down into that ink on the gel press. And the ink that I'm picking up, I'm stamping down onto a piece of whipped cream cardstock. So I'm not wasting that ink that I'm picking up. And that way I will be making two backgrounds with really the effort of one. So I will be also picking up the ink that's on the gel press with a piece of cardstock. All my pieces of cardstock are card front size, so 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. I will, in the end, I ended up trimming them down so that they would have a layer around them, but I like to just have some cut to that size so I can make quick and easy card fronts. And now I'm using the little flower from that set as a smaller image to fill in the open areas of these backgrounds. And there's also a little image that is like stacked triangles, and I'm using that as my smallest image to fill in the rest of the open spaces. So once that's done, I'm going to bring in a second piece of paper and we'll pick up the ink that's left on that gel press to get a second background. So the first background I made where I stamped the leaves will be the base of card number one, and then the other piece will be the inside of card number one. Now we're going to just take our same stamps, ink them with the same inks, and stamp that down onto the gel press. When you stamp onto this gel-like surface, you're going to get a different texture to your stamped images than if you were to stamp them directly onto the paper. And also there's a little remnant of the green ink on there from before, so we'll get a really light wash of green in the background of this background that we're going to pull next. So I'm just using all the same images that I did before, the leaf images, and stamping those randomly in a clustered area that will be a little bit bigger than my card front. And so having these three different shades of green really gives it a lot of depth, and they work well together, so it's going to be a good background. I'm pulling in some coral berry ink now to stamp the flower in there. I thought a little splash of pink would be fun, so just randomly stamping that. Again, having the smaller images to fill in those open spaces is really what helps when you're making your own backgrounds, helps fill it in. All right, so let's check that out. And this background number three will become the base of my second card that I'm making today. Now I'm going to pull back that brayer. It had some ink on it still. I'm just kind of cleaning it off here onto my gel press. And then I'm going to take that triangle stamp, and I just stamped it repeatedly all over this to give it some texture. Really only the first one I stamped showed up. So I wish I would have stamped it off onto a scratch paper each time before picking up more ink from the gel press. But this subtle background is actually going to become the inside of card number two. So I'm going to use all four of these backgrounds today, making two cards. All right, so let's make some more pieces that will go on the front of our card. I'm using almond butter ink to stamp the branch onto oatmeal cookie cardstock. That sounds pretty yummy. Oatmeal cookie with almond butter? Yeah, yummy. And then I'll die cut that branch with the coordinating die, and then I'm going to just kind of throw my elements down here on my card so I can visualize where I want to put the sentiment that says token of my appreciation. Not token, toucan. Toucan of my appreciation. So cute. So I am going to emboss this. So I treated the paper with an anti-static powder tool, and then I'm stamping the image with that coral berry ink that I used on the beak. And I'm going to do this repeatedly so it's a good saturation of ink so that pink will show up on top of the green leaves. So I stamped it three times, and then I'm going to clean it off. And this fourth time, I will ink it up with clear pigment ink. So having a stamp positioning tool means that I can stamp a second kind of ink over the top, and I'm able to now emboss with that very easily, just sprinkling on the clear powder again, and then heating that up with my heat gun to melt the powder. And you can see how that sits right on top of the green ink, but you can still see through it a tiny bit. Now here's where I decided to trim my paper down a little bit more to 3 7/8 by 5 1/8. Then I'm able to mount that onto a layer of black cardstock that measures 4 by 5 1/4. And this will be the layer that goes onto my card base. I love having that very thin layer of black all the way around. It just is kind of a border that helps draw your eye into the center of the card. And I just put a heavy block on there to flatten it out a little bit because the paper was a tiny bit warped at the top from being embossed. So I'm going to stamp the largest solid flower from this stamp set with frosty pink ink. And then the outline flower that I used on the background earlier is actually an outline for this image, and I'm going to stamp that with the coral berry. I decided to do a second set of these flowers with yellow colors, so I'm using Citrus Burst for my lightest color, and then I'll go back over the top of that with the outline image and Fresh Lemon. And once those are all stamped, I'm going to go ahead and die cut them with the coordinating die. And I'm going to use three of them for this card and maybe save three for later that I might use on card number two. And I'm laying these out on my card before I put the adhesive on just to get a feel for where they're going to go. And then I go ahead and adhere them down. So glue that branch into place. It hangs off the card a tiny bit. I didn't want it to look like it was floating in midair. So I let it hang off the side and then just trimmed off that excess piece. I'm going to mount my bird onto the card with some foam squares, and that will give it some dimension, which I love. I gotta have foam squares on all my cards. I love it. So that's there. And then I just played around with where I wanted the flowers to go. I liked this, but I felt like it covered up too much of the branch. And so I decided to put some flowers at the end of the branch, and I felt that really balanced out the card. So I will add those to my card with foam squares. And I liked one on the bird's head, and I just thought it was really cute. So I'll put that on, and that really adds to the look. Anytime I make a tropical card, I love to have tropical flowers. So I was so pleased that this set had two flowers in it. So that is that, and then this will get mounted to our card base which is a top folding card that measures 4 1/4 by 11 and is scored at 5.5. And you can see I'm mounting that onto the card with some foam tape to give it some more dimension. Now, to add a little bling to this card, I'm bringing in the Rainbow Drop set from Fun Stampers Journey, and I will glue or adhere a yellow rainbow drop to the center of each of the three flowers using glue dots. These don't have adhesive on the back. I found that glue dots work really well for these. So we'll get those stuck on, and that finishes up card number one. But then I decided it says token of appreciation. No, toucan of appreciation. So I wanted to make a gift card holder for the inside of the card. So I took that second background that we made that has kind of where I used the stamps to pick up the ink off the gel press. So you have like these white skeleton leaves in the background, and I'm stamping over the top with those same ink colors to kind of give it a really dimensional look. And this will just step up this background a little bit. So once I finish stamping that, I'm going to bring in a die set that creates a gift card holder. And it's from Fun Stampers Journey. It's the Gift Slide Die Set. And I will die cut that from the card. It's actually a two-piece die set. You can use the outer frame to die cut a square, and then the inner part die cuts the part where you slide the card in. I decided instead of wasting all my paper, I would just cut this down to fit, and then I will have a second piece I can save and use for something else later. So cut down, it measures 2 3/4 by 4 inches. And after I run that through the die machine, you see it makes a bow, and you just slide your gift card behind that bow. But when you glue it down, you really want to take note not to put any glue where the bow is, but everywhere else, because you want that back piece to stay stuck down really well. Meanwhile, the bow is not stuck down, which makes a nice little pocket to slide that in. And of course, if I'm making a tropical card, we should have an Amazon gift card, right? All right, so I die cut a second one of these and wanted to have a different colored bow. So this is Sweet Berry cardstock from Fun Stampers Journey. And once I stuck it down, I decided I didn't really like the whole long bow. So I'm just going to cut the top and the bottom off at a little bit of a rounded angle, and then I can glue just that on so it has a pink bow right in the center for a little bit of contrast. And once that's all dry, then I can add my gift card back in. And now I decided I was done with card number one. A token of appreciation would be the gift card, right? All right, so there we have it. Let's move on to card number two. We're going to be using this background, which was the third background that I made, and I'm going to fill in those flowers with some frosty pink ink just to give it a little bit more color, a little pop of color in there. And this background is going to get a little bit more wild and crazy as we go. I had so much fun with this card. I love it. And then I took the Citrus Burst ink and the little triangle image and added in little dots or little specks of yellow, little triangles of yellow, just to add a little bit more color. And that will not be the end of this background, because after this, I decided I would splatter it. I love to splatter. If you watch my videos, you've probably seen me do this lots of times. So I brought in my Fresh Sage Silk, and I'm splattering that over the card. When this silk dries, both of these have a little bit of a shimmer to them, so it's really cool look to this card. So I just really splattered the heck out of them, and check out this background. So fun. All right, so while that dries, I'm going to go ahead and stamp my bird for this card, and the same way I stamped the bird for the first card. For the second bird on this card, I wanted a reverse image. So I'm inking that up again with my VersaFine Onyx Black ink, and I'm going to stamp that down very gently onto my gel press. And then I'm going to bring my paper in and pick up that print, which will give me a reverse image of this bird. Now you will notice, just like the leaves before, you have a textured image. And I really thought that that looked cool, but you'll see how I transform it for this particular card. So I die cut my bird, and then for the reversed image, I'm holding that up to the light and putting my die face up or cut side up to the back of the image. And then I went ahead and die cut that. Now let's stamp the beaks. So for the first bird, I'm doing Coral Berry and Frosty Pink ink for all of the accent pieces. And then for the second bird, I'm going to bring back in the yellow colors. I'm going to do Fresh Lemon. So I die cut a piece of just the bird that is just the head. And then I'm going to use Fresh Lemon ink to ink up the beaks. And you can see there, I use the negative piece from the bird I just die cut as a guide to stamp them. Then that yellow piece that I die cut, I can lay in there and pick up that image. So it's lined up. I didn't have to guess. And then you can see here that it is a real subtle look, but it works. So I'm going to just cut around this, and this yellow piece can get glued on to my bird. I bet you wondered why his whole beak wasn't cut. I didn't really need the whole beak. So now I have my two birds, and I don't mind the speckled look of the second bird in general, but you'll see how I fill it in later. Just because this background is so busy, I felt like he needed to be solid and not add to the busyness of this card. So I'm stamping the large image, Wild About You, with that same VersaFine Onyx Black ink. I'm going to ink this up and stamp it down three times just to make it really bold, really saturated over the top of this background. It doesn't quite stamp over the splatters. The splatters show through it the most. And then again, I'm adding this onto a layer of black cardstock, so it's got that thin black border all the way around that I loved from the first card. Pressing that into place, and then I can add my birds on with foam squares. And right here is where I decided this bird needed to be colored in. So I took my black Zig Clean Color Real Brush Marker, say that fast five times, and I'm just using that to trace around the image and color it in. And like I said before, this background is really busy, and so the speckled look of this bird I felt just was too much. I needed to let the background be the busy thing and not the bird. So you could color this in or you could leave it. And then I'm going to stamp with maple yellow, another of those stacked line images on his beak. It just needed a little bit more interest. And then when I die cut it, the die got off a tiny bit around the tail. So I'm just going to trim that down so it doesn't look so obvious. And that just finishes up my bird, and I'm really pleased with it. So the eye on the bird with the yellow, because stamping it on the gel press, it gave it a little white border. And then I felt my pink bird needed a little white border. So I brought in a white gel pen and added a little white accent to the eye. And I later, off camera, added white accents to the black part of the yellow bird as well. So you'll see that in the final pictures. Look for it. And then it kind of matches the white lines in the other bird. So I mounted this card base or card front to a card base that is bubblegum cardstock with foam squares, and then I'm accenting the card with some more of those rainbow drops. And now for the inside of this card, I'm taking background number 4 and stamping down some of those open image leaves just on areas of this background that I thought were particularly cool. And then I'm going to fussy cut those, and they will be some cute little accents for the inside of this card. Aren't they cool? I love them. So we'll glue those down on the inside of this card, and then I'll bring in the pink flower left over from card number 1 to glue on here as well. So that pretty much finishes up these cards with the Toucan Paradise stamp set. I hope you've enjoyed them and learned a little bit about gel press printmaking. If you're interested in gel press itself, I have a lot more videos. I'll link a couple for you in the description below, as well as all the products that I use to make today's cards. If you are new to my channel, I would love for you to subscribe. I have new videos every week, and I just thank you for coming to watch, and I hope you have a fabulous weekend. Happy stamping! Bye!